What do you call a real estate market that has a never-ending supply of buyers, almost no homes for sale, crazy bidding wars, and super high home prices? Some people might even call it the nightmare in real estate right now. Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name is Samantha, and what I just described is what we call in real estate a seller's market. Now, if you're watching this video in May of 2021, you might be saying, Sam, duh, everybody knows it's a seller's market right now. But the reality is, if you are a first-time home buyer or you're just starting the home buying process, you may not fully understand what a seller's market is and what it might actually mean to you as a buyer. You might also be watching this video sometime in the very far future from May of 2021, and the market could be completely different. So I thought it was a very simple question that I wanted to answer in this week's video. What is a seller's market? Now, the term seller's market isn't specific to real estate. Obviously, that's the context I'm going to be talking about it today. But in very basic terms, a seller's market means that there's more demand for something than there is supply. So the person or the item that's, you know, the supply or the supplier has all the leverage because they have what everybody wants. They have the item or the product or the service that everybody is looking for. So in terms of real estate, that means the houses that are for sale versus the buyers that actually want to buy them. Now, there are two obvious ways you can tell that you are in a seller's real estate market. And the first one is if you're physically out in the market, what you're observing. So for example, if you're out shopping for a house right now and you're going to open houses and you're seeing homes with your real estate agent, then you know exactly what I'm about to describe. You are seeing homes sell really, really fast. You're seeing homes spending hours or days at maximum on the market before they're already, you know, they're being snatched up really, really quickly. You're seeing lines out of the house, sometimes around the block for open houses. You're seeing your agent have a challenge with actually scheduling showings because there's so many showings already booked. And then obviously, if you are going and making an offer on a house and your agent calls the listing agent and they tell you, we have multiple offers. That is how you can tell right away that you are currently buying and shopping in a seller's market. You can see the demand for the homes that are out there and that there's just not enough supply to be meeting the demand. So in that case, it's very obvious that the seller is holding all the cards and they hold all the leverage in the transaction. Now, the second way you can tell that you are in a seller's market, if you're not out shopping yet and you haven't experienced those things that I just described, there is a more analytical approach to determining whether or not you're actually in a seller's market or where in the seller's market, like how deep into it are you? And that's by looking at some of the numbers. So the metric you actually use to determine what type of a market you're in is what we call months of inventory. So basically what that means is every market, based on the statistics, based on how many homes are selling per month, you can determine how many months of inventory a particular town, city, county, or even state might have. So what that means is if we have, let's say, 30 homes for sale and homes are selling at about 30 homes a month, that means if we had zero new houses come on the market, we only had those 30 houses, at the rate houses are selling, all of those homes would be sold in 1 month. Now let's use that same example, and let's say there's 180 homes for sale. Instead of 30, we now have 180 homes for sale, assuming that no other homes come on the market and the market stays at selling approximately 30 homes a month, then that means that that area actually has approximately 6 months worth of inventory, meaning if no other houses come on the market at 30 homes per month, 6 months would exhaust the inventory levels. And if we look at that same market area example again, and we increase the inventory to 240 homes, again, zero homes coming on the market, 30 selling per month, then it would take approximately 8 months to sell out of the inventory completely. Now, the reason I wanted to show you some quick examples of the different amounts of months inventory is because what I just described to you basically was an example of a seller's market, a balanced market, and a buyer's market. So in the real estate industry, anything less than 6 months is deemed a seller's market. And anything more than 6 months is actually deemed a buyer's market. Now, anything more than 6 months, you're actually gonna have more homes to sell than you have buyers. So then the buyers hold all the leverage. But the reason I wanted to sort of explain that to you is because I wanted to talk a little bit about how many months of inventory and when you can start to feel the effects of whether or not it's a seller's or buyer's market. So for example, I just pulled up the statistics this morning for Cobb County and Cherokee County right here in Georgia. And Cobb County is currently sitting at only a 1 month inventory. 1 month, that's it. That's super low. And Cherokee County actually sitting at 2 months inventory, and they flip-flop back and forth this whole year between 2 months and 1 month, but right now we're sitting at about 2 months inventory in Cherokee County. Now, if you're out there and shopping and you are looking at a market that only has 1, 2, or even 3 months inventory, that's when you're really gonna feel the strong effects of it being a seller's market. That's when you're gonna feel the competition, you're gonna see the home selling fast, the prices going, you know, raising up really high, and you're gonna be in bidding war after bidding war. Around month 4, you might stop feeling the effects of the seller's market. It might really depend on the house and the price point. You kind of see it narrowing down a little bit. And in month 5 inventory, and definitely in 6 month inventory, you're really not going to feel the effects of it being a seller's market. You're not going to have bidding wars anymore. You're not going to see lines for open houses down the street. It's what we would consider more of a balanced market. And then anything over 6 month inventory, well, then you're really going to start to feel that as a buyer. You're going to start to feel the fact that you can negotiate the price a little bit more. You're going to see homes sitting on the market a little bit longer, and you're going to see that you as a buyer have a little bit more leverage in terms of the negotiation. I think it's important that if you're going to be buying or selling a home, whether now or in the future, it's important to understand what is the real estate market doing right now in your area. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I really hope you found this information helpful. If you have an idea for a future video or a real estate related question, go ahead and leave it in the comments section below. And if you're out there shopping, trying to buy a home in this crazy seller's market, I wish you the best of luck. I'll see you next week. 6 times 3 is 2.